patrons. This is a good example of, you know, Dylan's genius in writing, also in songwriting, in structure and rhyming. He uses different grammatical expressions. I don't even know the names, alliterations, metonymy, various terms. An example, just so you understand what I'm saying, is like in Tangled Up in Blue, he says, I muttered something underneath my breath. She studied the lines in my face. I must admit I felt a little uneasy when she bent down to tie the laces of my shoe, Tangled Up in Blue. So he just flips it, because it's like face, lace, which rhymed, but then it's like off my shoe, Tangled Up in Blue, which is, not everybody does that, you know.
Yeah.
It sounds very simple. I think Eric Clapton once said that when you hear a Bob Dylan song, you feel that everything is out of place. But then you hear it again, you realize it's in the perfect place and you can't do anything about it. And that's really how he is. Like, his words are always a little ahead or a little behind. For him, phrasing is very important, the way he speaks about each thing.
All right.
I hope that makes sense.
It makes total sense. And we're going to now listen to Simple Twist of Fate.
Simple Twist of Fate. Another beautiful, beautiful song. Yeah, they sat together in the park. I mean, it's so beautiful. I mean, like, what does it mean? It's difficult to say what it means. They sat together in the park, and as the evening sky grew dark, she looked at him, and he felt a spark tingle to his bones. It was then that he felt alone and wished that he'd gone straight and watched out for a simple twist of fate. Beautiful.